Number 9. What is it? The chupacabra is a legendary beast from the folklore of the Americas. In the past decades, there have been several alleged chupacabra sightings, and the creature has been the subject of various descriptions. The chupacabra's reported physical characteristics range from it being reptile-like, with humanoid features, to a monstrous breed of wild dog. The creature's name is derived from the verb chupa, which means to suck, and the noun cabra, meaning goat. The term was coined in Puerto Rico, where reports of the beast first started coming out. Known to target domestic animals and kill them by bleeding them dry, the chupacabra is, for true believers, a monster to be reckoned with. Reported sightings of this terrifying creature have been as recent as 2019, in areas of the world far beyond its supposed natural habitat. Number 8. Vampire of Mocha. Before the chupacabra rose to international notoriety, a series of strange incidents took place in the small Puerto Rican town of Mocha during 1975. Fear gripped the area as farmers reported their animals being slaughtered and drained of blood. There were numerous such incidents, and soon enough, sightings and stories of a monstrous winged beast started to emerge. One local claimed to have been attacked by a horrible creature covered in feathers and had barely managed to escape. While reports on the monster's description varied, the animal killings continued on a list that primarily included goats and sheep, but also pigs, cows, and poultry. Aside from deep scratches, they also exhibited circular incisions through which the blood had been drained. The incidents were initially attributed to a satanic cult, but local newspapers eventually started writing about El Vampiro de Mocha, meaning the Mocha vampire. Law enforcement and civilian patrols tried to track down the source of the bizarre animal killings, but their efforts ultimately proved fruitless. The first attacks had started in February 1975, and by July there were no more reported incidents. Nobody knows what the vampire of Mocha actually represented or what ultimately became of it. 2 decades later, the attacks resumed, this time in the town of Canavanas. Number 7. El Chupacabras. The descriptions of the chupacabra as they began in 1995 seemed to largely forego the wings and feathers associated with the vampire of Mocha in favor of a more reptile-like appearance. As such, the chupacabra has been described as being 4.5 to 5.5 feet tall, with scaly or leathery skin that's a combination of green and gray in color. Its eyes are wide and black, but have also been reported to glow bright under certain circumstances. The monster owns a set of gruesome protruding fangs, which are arguably its most dangerous weapon. It's a rather heavy creature with thin arms, clawed digits, and sharp spines or quills running down its back. The reptile-like version of the chupacabra has been spotted moving in a bipedal manner as well as on four legs. It's also been said that it has the ability of quickly hopping around in a manner similar to that of a kangaroo, using its muscular hind legs. Bat-like wings were still sparingly reported after 1995. The chupacabra typically strikes under the cover of darkness and goes after pets or farm animals for an easy blood meal. Number 6. Where is it located? The first person to have seen the chupacabra in 1995 was a woman named Madeline Tolentino. She briefly spotted the creature outside her window in Canavanas, Puerto Rico. Tolentino provided the first description of the chupacabra, which seemed to resemble a reptile and alien hybrid. Interestingly enough, she spotted the monstrous being at a time when numerous pets and farm animals had been killed in and around the town. Prior to Tolentino's sighting, 8 dead sheep had been discovered. They'd reportedly been drained of blood through puncture marks in their chest area. Over 150 animals were subsequently slaughtered in the region, all exhibiting the same wounds and all of them having been drained of blood. Puerto Rican comedian Silverio Perez is credited for coining the chupacabra term during a radio station interview, since the monster seemed to have a preference for goats. Other reports started emerging throughout South America in countries like Brazil, Argentina, Colombia, El Salvador, Chile, and others. It wasn't long before the chupacabra legend made its way through Panama towards Mexico and the United States. Yet, as the legend spread by the early 2000s, the chupacabra had taken on a rather new appearance. Number 5. Sightings in the US. The US sightings of the monster marked an interesting transition for the chupacabra, as it was known from Tolentino's first report. They described a creature that was closer to a mammal, potentially a new breed of wild dog. It was hairless with pronounced eye sockets and a protruding spinal ridge, as well as claws and fangs. Yet unlike previous sightings, the US reports also produced some alleged chupacabra bodies for further examination. About a dozen were recovered in Texas and in other southwestern states. The bodies presented several of the features that have been described in the sightings. They were hairless, had a gaunt appearance, and looked as if their skin had been thickened by burning. DNA samples would urge a conclusion that was less than extraordinary. Most of the beasts were actually coyotes and dogs suffering from sarcoptic mange. It's a skin disease caused by the parasitic mite Sarcoptes scabii. This condition had actually been responsible for their terrifying appearance. It had also weakened the animals, thus forcing them to attack livestock, as it was easier than chasing after deer or rabbits. The reports in the US would definitely dispel some of the chupacabra mythos. But there were many questions still left unanswered. One of the mysteries was the quarter-inch holes that looked as if they'd been inflicted with surgical precision. It wasn't long before reports of livestock being slaughtered in similar ways started to emerge from parts of the world outside the Americas. Number 4. How will it kill you? The chupacabra isn't known to prey on humans, at least not according to the lore as it has been presented so far. That being said, there have been several instances of the chupacabra wandering into human settlements. One woman claimed that it had broken into her bedroom and then jumped out for the window as soon as she opened the door. It allegedly left a trail of slime and pieces of meat in its wake. Moreover, most of the reports describe a beast fully capable of killing an unarmed adult human. The injuries associated with its attacks on farm animals are arguably terrifying and denote a creature of substantial strength. Some animals have been described as having broken bones or puncture marks that had penetrated their skulls. This would mean that the chupacabra's bite is powerful enough and its fangs are sturdy enough to pierce through bone. In Puerto Rico alone, the creature has been connected to the death of over 1,000 animals. A number of strange animal deaths in the US weren't consistent with canine attacks, as the bodies also exhibited uncharacteristically deep slashes. Numerous alleged chupacabra attacks were also reported in Mexico. The information gathered from various sources around the world point to a nocturnal predator that stalks livestock and then ambushes them. Should an attack on a human occur, it would most likely have to do with the victim interrupting the chupacabra's feeding. At this point, the monster might turn its attention on the intruder. A swift attack would likely follow, commencing with punishing claw strikes. Once the chupacabra sees an opening, it would likely sink its fangs in the victim's body and start sucking their blood. Judging by the monster's reported size, it wouldn't be long until the victim would be fully drained. These are, of course, theories based on the current information and the hunting techniques of similarly built predators. Reports of chupacabra attacks on humans have, so far, been very limited. Number 3. Possible explanations. There have been several scientific explanations for the sightings, killing techniques, and the appearance of the chupacabra. In the US, chupacabra sightings have been mostly explained as misidentified mangy canines. In Mexico, they've sometimes been interpreted as misidentifications of stray Mexican hairless dogs. Circling back to the first sighting in 1995, there were certain questionable aspects about Madeleine Tolentino's story. Her description was almost identical to the alien creature Sill in the 1995 sci-fi horror movie Species. It had recently been released in Puerto Rico. Tolentino actually told a journalist investigating the chupacabra she believed the events of the movie had started taking place in the country at that time. Skeptics subsequently regarded her report as unreliable and the existence of the monster improbable. Necropsies of alleged chupacabra killings revealed that the animals hadn't been drained of blood. The false reports were attributed to farmers who didn't understand the natural process of lividity. When an animal dies, its heart stops pumping and blood seeps to the lower part of the body where it coagulates and thickens. This creates an illusion that they'd been drained of blood. As for the actual killings, they were attributed to regular predators which were either injured or inexperienced. After biting into the farm animals, they fled, unable to finish them off. The animals later died from circulatory shock or internal bleeding. For some, these explanations proved plausible enough to put the chupacabra into the realm of myth. Others, however, still believe the creature is real, and as of the making of this video, sightings continue to be reported. Today's topic was requested by Quinn Harris. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2. Possible origin. A number of theories have emerged regarding the origin of the chupacabra. It has even been connected to various conspiracy theories, such as extraterrestrial visits and top secret experiments undertaken by the US government. These mainly have to do with its gray skin and large, oval eyes, as well as its supposed humanoid appearance. One proposition is that it was created through a hybridization of extraterrestrial samples and animal, potentially human DNA. The experiment would have produced several specimens that either escaped or were purposefully released into the wild. The areas chosen for their release would have been rural regions in developing countries where they could breed and eat undetected. Other theories entertain the possibility of a beast that's simply the result of natural evolution that expertly adapted to avoid human detection. Official They Will Kill You merchandise is now available at theywillkillyou.com. Some of it is to die for. Number 1. Recent sighting. The most recent chupacabra sighting, as of the making of this video, has occurred outside the Americas. In the summer of 2019, a strange creature was sighted by traders at the Shershah flea market in Pakistan. A watchman reported a strange creature the likes of which he hadn't seen in 25 years of holding the post. It was nearly 5 feet tall with scaly skin and large, glowing eyes. It was reportedly capable of jumping nearly 20 feet in a single bound. The very next day, a second watchman spotted the same creature. It had reportedly killed 11 goats at one of the market's warehouses. As fear gripped traders and more people claimed to have seen the otherworldly creature, the police was involved. The initial assumption was that it was a practical joke, but the investigation has yet to confirm or deny that theory. Thanks for watching. Would you rather wake up to find a chupacabra in your bedroom or spend a month on a deserted island with your significant other's parents? Let us know in the comments section below.